So tonight it's down to closing arguments in the murder trial of Mark Leonard, the man prosecutors say is the mastermind behind the Southside explosion that killed two people and damaged more than 100 homes.
Prosecutors made their case for the past 5 weeks, calling in Leonard's neighbors, ex-girlfriend, and even sister. And they even have one of the best forensic experts they could find to build the case against Leonard. Now the defense spent about an hour trying to convince the jury that Leonard never meant to kill anyone. Now among the last thing jurors heard was a portion of an interview from Eyewitness News with Leonard's ex-girlfriend, Monserrate Shirley.
I'm going home, and she said it's not home to go to. The house is gone. Everything is gone.
The Night Beat's Rich Van Wyk has the final day of testimony and when the jury will start deciding Mark Leonard's fate.
Mark Leonard's defense was short and simple. It was aimed at discrediting the testimony of perhaps the best witness against him, his ex-girlfriend, Monserrate Shirley. Leonard's attorneys finished their case, showing jurors an Eyewitness News interview with Shirley shortly after the explosion.
She was screaming, I'm glad you're alive, I'm glad you're alive. It was an explosion in the neighborhood, and we were looking for your body.
In addition to her surprise of the explosion, Shirley went on about visiting the casino, boarding their cat Snowball, and problems with the home's furnace and thermostat. The police officer who interviewed and later arrested Shirley testified she denied any knowledge of the explosion or who might be responsible. The blast destroyed or damaged more than 100 homes. The couple next door, Jennifer and Dion Longworth, were killed. During the trial, defense attorneys hammered away at Shirley's believability, changing her story, they said, and naming Leonard as the instigator and organizer of the plot only after receiving a plea agreement that significantly reduces her prison time. Leonard is charged with fraud, conspiracy, arson, and murder. However, jurors will be given the choice of convicting him of a much less serious crime of reckless homicide.
The status of the law is that they're entitled to the instruction. The Indiana Supreme Court has spoken on that, so I'm not going to take issue with that. Obviously, we'll be arguing our case.
In their opening statements to jurors, Leonard's attorneys called this a simple insurance fraud that went horribly wrong, insisting the explosion was unintended. It was supposed to be a small fire, and precautions were taken to see no one was hurt. It is possible those same claims will be made Monday morning in closing arguments to jurors. In South Bend, Rich Van Wyk, Channel 13, Eyewitness News.